Good morning, girls. Welcome back to Science 2 class. Hope all are sitting with pen, pencil, notebook, and textbook. In previous class, we studied the 5 criteria used for new system of animal classification. This flowchart gives the classification of animals as per those criteria. Girls, draw this flowchart in your notebook and learn it. Let us study the characters of each phylum in more detail. Phylum Porifera. They are called as sponges. These are multicellular, asymmetric, aquatic organisms without cell wall and without body cavity. Their body is porous. Pores are called as ostia and oscula. Water is taken through the ostia and given out through the osculum. Since they are attached to substratum, they cannot leave their place. Therefore, they are called sedentary animals. They possess special collar cells to produce current in the water, which help them catch the food. Their body is supported by spicules made up of calcium carbonate and silica. They reproduce by budding. Budding is a type of asexual reproduction in which a new organism develops from an outgrowth or bud formed on the body due to cell division. They are capable of regeneration. Regeneration means the regrowth of a damaged or missing part from the remaining tissue. Girls, let us see the examples. Sea corn, bath sponge. These are the examples of Porifera. Look at the pictures and observe them. Next phylum is Coelenterata or Cnidaria. These are multicellular diploblastic organisms without cell wall, having radial symmetry. Most of them are marine. Body is cylindrical or umbrella-like. Cylindrical body is called polyp and umbrella-like is called medusa. Body of hydra is cylindrical, whereas jellyfish is umbrella-like. They have tentacles to catch the prey and nidoblast or stinging cell which secretes and injects the toxin in the prey. These are the organs of offense and defense. Corals, sea anemone are some more examples. The colonies of specific cnidarians are known as coral reefs. These are found in ocean. A precious stone, coral, is used in jewelry. And also, ash obtained from corals is used in Ayurvedic medicine. Let us move to next phylum, that is Platyhelminthes. These are multicellular triploblastic acoelomate having bilateral symmetry. Body is slender, flat-like, hence are called flatworms. Most of them are endoparasite. That is, live in the internal organs of host. They are hermaphrodite, means male and female reproductive organs are present on same animal. For example, Planaria liver fluke, tapeworm, etc. Let us learn about phylum Aesculenthes. These are multicellular triploblastic pseudocoelomate animals having bilateral symmetry. Body is long, thread-like or cylindrical, hence they are called as roundworms. They are either free-living or endoparasites. They are unisexual, that is, male and female sexes are separate. For example, Ascaris, the worm found in the intestine, filarial worm, it causes filariasis. Next phylum is Annelida. These are multicellular triploblastic eucoelomate animals having bilateral symmetry, body is long cylindrical, they have setae or parapodia, that is necessary processes for locomotion. These are either hermaphrodite or unisexual. Girls observe the pictures of earthworm, nereis, leech. Earthworm moves in soil, feeds on the decomposing dead plants and animals. Therefore, soil is loosened due to these activities. Its excreta enriches the soil. That's why earthworm is called as friends of farmers. In Ayurveda, leeches are used to suck and remove impure blood from the body of patient. Let us move to next phylum, that is Arthropoda. It is largest phylum containing highest number of animals on earth. These are multicellular triploblastic eucelomate segmented animals having bilateral symmetry and jointed appendages. These are omnipresent, that is found everywhere in soil, air and water. These are unisexual animals having a semi-transparent cover made up of chitin on their body. For example, crab, spider, scorpion, cockroach, etc. Some insects like honeybee, lake insect, silkworm are useful to us. Butterflies are helpful for the pollination. But some insects like mosquitoes, bedbugs, lice spread diseases. The standing crop in the fields can be totally ruined by insects. The group of short-horned grasshoppers known as locusts can damage the crops when they attack in thousands at a time. Pakistan and Somalia have recently declared locust emergencies. In India, five states, Rajasthan, Punjab, Gujarat, Maharashtra, and Madhya Pradesh are affected by locusts. Next phylum is Mollusca. It is second largest phylum. Body of these animals is multicellular triploblastic eucelomate, non-segmented and soft. It shows bilateral symmetry. Body is divided into three parts, head, foot and visceral mass, which is covered with a hard shell. Most are aquatic and unisexual. For example, octopus, snail, etc. Let us study the characters of phylum Echinodermata. The body of these animals is covered with spines made up of calcium carbonate. These are multicellular triploblastic eucelomate animals. They are found only in ocean. They are provided with two feet for locomotion and for capturing the prey. These are unisexual and have good ability of regeneration. For example, starfish, sea cucumber, etc. Next phylum is Hemichordata. The meaning of Hemichordata is half chordate. They are also known as acorn worms. They have notochord in proboscis region. Proboscis means a sucking organ. These are multicellular triploblastic and divided into three parts, proboscis, collar and trunk. These are marine animals and live in burrows in the sand. They have pharyngeal gill slits for respiration. They are unisexual or hermaphrodite. For example, balanoglossus and sacoglossus. Girls, I hope you followed this. Collect more information from the net about above phyla. Read the lesson carefully. Write and learn the characteristics of each phylum. Thank you. Take care.